Hi, welcome to this first part of my video playlist about the best methods for converting aliphatic alcohols into alkyl chlorides. This first presentation is about the use of hydrogen chloride as deoxychlorinating reagent. This is the most environmentally friendly and least expensive reagent available, but unfortunately not all alcohols, but only acid-resistant alcohols can be converted into chlorides with hydrogen chloride. The conversion of alcohols into chlorides is an important transformation because alcohols are readily available but can usually not be used as alkylating reagents. The corresponding alkyl chlorides, though, are electrophilic alkylating reagents and can be used to alkylate a broad variety of nucleophiles, such as amines, thiols, alcohols, aromatics, and deprotonated CH acidic compounds. There are some few cases of direct alkylations with alcohols, for instance, the high-temperature methylation of phenol with methanol, or alkylations with electron-rich benzylic alcohols. But alkyl chlorides are always more reactive and more versatile electrophiles than the corresponding alcohols. Alkyl chlorides can also be suitable starting materials for the preparation of organometallic reagents, olefins, or alkanes. Non-activated alkyl chlorides are, however, not very reactive, as shown in this table. The quaternization of quinuclidine, for instance, proceeds 40 to 80 times faster with alkyl bromides than with chlorides. Although most alkylating reagents are mutagenic and otherwise toxic, some alkyl chlorides are sufficiently unreactive to allow their use as food additives or drugs. Examples include sucralose and chloramphenicol. More reactive than alkyl chlorides are alkyl bromides, iodides, or sulfonates. But these are more expensive than alkyl chlorides, and their high reactivity is not always required, and can even be a problem if these compounds have to be stored. Bromide and iodide waste is also more costly to dispose of than chloride, and therefore alkyl chlorides should always be considered first as potential electrophiles for a given alkylation reaction. The mechanism of the conversion of aliphatic alcohols into chlorides by treatment with hydrogen chloride depends on the structure of the alcohol and on the solvent. Alcohols which readily form carbocations will react by an SN1 type mechanism, while less reactive alcohols will usually not form free carbocations but undergo a bimolecular nucleophilic substitution. Typical side reactions are the formation of ethers, of olefins, and of isomerized alkyl chlorides. The formation of ethers may be suppressed by increasing the amount of hydrochloric acid, but isomerizations are difficult to prevent under acidic reaction conditions. In this case, a deoxychlorination under basic reaction conditions may be the easiest way to solve the problem. Because of the potential formation of carbocations, deoxychlorinations with hydrogen chloride can proceed with stereochemical inversion or yield mixtures of stereoisomers. Examples are also known where the substitution of the hydroxyl group by chloride proceeded with retention of configuration, for instance, when using zinc chloride as catalyst. In such reactions, a tight ion pair is probably formed in which chloride is transferred to the carbocation from the side of the hydroxyl group. If a solvent is required, this should be acid-resistant, as for instance chloroalkanes, chlorobenzene or water. Toluene can sometimes also be used, but may also undergo Friedel-Crafts alkylation. Less suitable are MTBE, esters, nitriles, and ketones, because these undergo hydrolysis, cleavage, or condensation reactions in the presence of hydrogen chloride. The suitability of ethers also depends on their resistance to acids. Dioxane and THF can sometimes be used, but will usually be cleaved under forcing reaction conditions. Deoxychlorinations with hydrogen chloride can be catalyzed by Lewis acids, such as zinc chloride, and often proceed better in the presence of high concentrations of chloride. Therefore, amine hydrochlorides are sometimes used to facilitate these reactions. If a starting alcohol is only sparsely soluble in water and aqueous hydrochloric acid is to be used as reagent, phase transfer catalysts may also enhance the reaction rate. This example, conducted continuously, shows how tetrabutyl ammonium chloride, acting both as phase transfer catalyst and as chloride source, can enhance the reaction rate of deoxychlorinations with aqueous hydrogen chloride. Interestingly, despite the high tendency of primary carbocations to isomerize to secondary carbocations, no secondary alkyl chlorides or ethers were formed in this instance. This is a further optimized example of the use of an ammonium chloride to facilitate the deoxychlorination of alcohols by HCl. Again, as in the previous example, a high temperature was required, but a clean conversion to the desired chloride occurred. The use of zinc chloride as catalyst enables deoxychlorinations at lower temperature, as shown here. The continuous removal of the product from the reaction mixture by distillation is a practical way to prevent its acid-catalyzed isomerization. In this example, a sensitive, readily carbocation-forming alcohol was converted into chloride with aqueous hydrochloric acid. Because of the high reactivity of the starting alcohol, the reaction already proceeded at room temperature. However, due to its propensity to form carbocations, the product must be highly reactive and can probably not be stored for long. So, what are the potential side reactions? Many carbocations show a high tendency to isomerize by hydride migration or Wagner-Meerwein rearrangement. A careful analysis of the products formed upon deoxychlorinating menthol with aqueous hydrochloric acid revealed a large number of such carbocation-derived byproducts. Interestingly, the main chloride was formed with retention of configuration. A further example of acid-mediated rearrangement of carbon-carbon bonds is the reaction of cyclopropyl methanol with hydrogen chloride. Here, the main product is cyclobutyl chloride, and only small amounts of cyclopropyl methyl chloride are formed. This suggests that the cyclopropyl methyl cation is less stable than the cyclobutyl cation, and that mostly the latter would be present in an equilibrated mixture of carbocations. Further side reactions include allylic rearrangements, the addition of hydrogen chloride to alkenes or alkynes, the formation of ethers, and the displacement of other leaving groups by chloride, for instance of other halides, sulfonates, alkoxides, or carboxylates. Then a number of other functional groups than alcohols may also undergo deoxychlorination or hydrolysis in the presence of aqueous HCl, such as acetals, ethers, epoxides, esters, amides, nitriles, carbamates, alkyl arenes, and triaryl methanes. Here are some further examples. Because few functional groups are compatible with strongly acidic reaction conditions, this reaction has mostly been used for simple, unfunctionalized aliphatic alcohols. For structurally complex starting alcohols, more selective deoxychlorinating reagents will usually be required, which are presented in the following videos of this playlist.